Welcome to Inside Roanoke. I'm Melinda Mayo, the Communications and Media Officer for the City of Roanoke. Today we're here in Elmwood Park because we're going to talk about downtown winter activities. We're also going to hear about the Go Green Virginia Award and a lot more, so stay with us.
Dude, where'd you get that shirt at Goodwill?
I did, actually. I like it. Don't you have something better to do?
Want to learn how to manage your money better, save for that car or dream home, or be able to bounce back from bad credit mistakes? Bank On Roanoke Valley can help. Bank On works with local banks, credit unions, and local governments to offer free classes at local libraries in our community. It's easy, free, and it's happening right where you live. Check out the calendar of classes or sign up at bankonrv.org or call 777-4200 for more information.
Welcome back, and my guest is Jamie Clark with Downtown Roanoke Incorporated. Jamie, there's some activities happening during our winter months, and I wanted you to share with our viewers what those are. Start by talking about the Elmwood on Ice.
Sure.
Where is that going to happen and when?
Elmwood on Ice, presented by Valley Star Credit Union, actually starts up on November 21st, and it's going to be right here where we're standing.
Wow.
So we'll be putting an ice rink right here in downtown Roanoke that's open until January 27th, so it's a great time to come downtown and skate. Or come watch the kids skate and enjoy everything downtown has to offer.
Well, tell us about the hours, the fees. Talk about that part a little bit.
Sure. So it's open, like I said, the day before Thanksgiving on the 21st. Wednesdays and Thursdays from 4 to 9 p.m., Fridays 4 to 10, Saturday 11 a.m. to 10 p.m., and then Sunday is from noon to 7 p.m. When schools are out, we are actually open on those days. So if it's Monday or Tuesday when their school's out, we will have extended hours. The full schedule is available at elmwoodonice.com.
Okay.
As far as fees go, we do have an ice slide, and we have the skating rink, and we offer skate rentals, so you can actually do all of that for $10.
Oh, wow.
Or if you don't need skates or anything, there are some other separate pricing, but it's a great deal, and you can come downtown, you get a wristband, you can skate all day, so it's a great time to come down, skate, go grab something to eat, do a little shopping, and then come back again.
Yeah. And the other thing which everyone looks forward to in December is Dickens. Talk about the schedule for that.
Oh yes, Dickens is huge. First three Fridays in December. This year it falls a little bit later, so it's the 7th, 14th, and 21st.
Okay.
We have all everybody's favorite activities. So the big event on the 7th is the tree lighting, which
everybody
loves. They come down for that. The mayor will be there, so that's always exciting. The second Friday and the 14th we'll have the parade.
Right.
The Christmas parade, which comes down Jefferson Street onto Campbell Avenue. Mm-hmm. Huge parade, great turnout.
Mm-hmm.
And then the final night on the 21st we'll have the cold snow zone where you can actually sled downtown in front of the Taubman, and then we have the pet costume contest.
Right.
So those are always favorite activities. We've got a few new little things we're going to be throwing in that we haven't announced just yet as far as activities go. And then, of course, all the community performances and our vendors. You can do a ton of shopping. It's a great time to come downtown.
It is. Well, talk a little bit about why it's so important to have these events and bring people into our downtown.
Events are huge for downtown. They bring people down here that maybe haven't come before, or people from out of the area. We hear a lot of people that come, especially for Dickens of a Christmas, from out of the area, who are new to Roanoke, never been here, or who come every year. So it's fantastic to really showcase and show off what we have here in Roanoke. And then they come and they shop and they dine, and they, help our businesses down here as well, which is great for us and for them.
Anything else you want to add about winter activities? Have we covered it all?
Hopefully. there's a ton going on, even outside of the events that Downtown Roanoke Incorporated offers.
Mm-hmm.
We do have a calendar on our website where I would direct people to. It's downtownroanoke.org, and you click on events. So we've got everything listed on there, as well as additional details of our schedule of events. So just head over there if you have questions, and we'd love to see you downtown.
And that's the best place to get information about Elmwood on Ice and Dickens, right?
It is, absolutely.
Okay. Well, thank you. Everybody's looking forward to it.
Yes.
I appreciate you sharing it with us.
Thanks for having
me. We'll be right back.
What's up, punk? Send those books home for. They ain't gonna help you on the streets.
To study?
Yeah, man, you need to join our crew, a.k.a. the Cobra.
Yeah, ain't nobody messing with the Cobra.
I mean, I don't know. I kind of want to go to college.
Nah, man. I mean, we're just having some fun. Nobody in our gang gets caught anyway.
Well, I guess sure.
All right. Hey, look, Henry. You're going to keep rolling with us? You got to prove to me that you can hang.
Okay.
All right, then. Go.
Henry, what are you doing?
Every year, over 7,000 arrests result from gang activity. You could end up just like these criminals. Is that what you want?
Don't be a part of the problem. Be a part of the solution.
Welcome back. My guest is Nell Boyle. Nell is the sustainability coordinator for the city of Roanoke. Nell, we just won an award, the Go Green Virginia Award. Tell us about that. When and where did it happen?
So on October 1st, which was a Monday, Virginia Municipal League had an award ceremony for the Go Green Virginia Project. And what that is a whole certification across the organization of green practices. And Roanoke was listed as a platinum sponsor, or platinum certification. And Mayor Lee was there to pick up the award for us.
And some people may not know what VML is and why their recognition is important.
So it's Virginia Municipal League. And what they do, it's a nonprofit that is providing services for local governments, particularly cities. And they help us with education and resources and research and some legislative advocacy.
Yeah.
And so they give us a whole host of things so that we can operate a little bit better. The reason that we're excited about this is because they look across all of the state of Virginia and they see all of cities and how they're operating, and to get this platinum recognition is really a big honor. Yes.
Well, can you share a little bit of some of the criteria we had to meet to get the award?
Sure. So the interesting thing is it's got all the regular things that you would expect, like energy efficiency and water conservation. Okay. Things like recycling are included in there, but also, Melinda, we have things like procurement practices and things that our Parks and Rec team does in landscaping are also recognized in our fleet services. So they look really across the board, even at community engagement and staff incentives. So they are really looking at our whole platform of practices and really making a broad broad assessment of what we're doing.
Well, aside from the recognition itself, how does winning an award like that, how does it benefit the city and the community? What are the benefits?
So the best thing is clean water and clean air.
Yeah.
And we're protecting our natural resources for future generations, so that's really exciting. But, you know, it's really good business practices, so we get excited. It saves us money, too. So provides things for other areas we can put that money towards.
Right, and it also supports Roanoke's leadership as a sustainable community. Say a little bit about that.
Correct. So in 2006, we really started our whole sustainability initiative, and VML recognized this.
Okay.
So Roanoke was actually invited to be one of the pilot communities, and we actually participated in making the checklist and helping to work with other communities around to make sure that we got a good, strong checklist. So we've been participating from the beginning and been awarded platinum every year since.
Well, what's the significance of the Go Green Award initiative? I mean, it's important to local governments, but why is it so important that VML have this program and support it, promote it, and engage the communities? Why?
Well, I think it's something we all need to address. So, you know, all the cities around the state of Virginia understand that this is important that we address these environmental issues. But also, this is a big, extensive checklist.
Yeah.
So all the things that we're doing are great, but it also gives us a really good roadmap for where we want to go in the future and things that we might want to try.
Okay. Anything else you'd like our viewers to know about the sustainability program or our efforts to go green?
Well, you know, we continually try and improve. We've been doing a lot of things for a lot of years, but just as this award points out, it's citywide and it isn't just the energy efficiency and it's just not recycling. It's landscaping practices. It's practices in our own offices of recycling and using recycled paper and things like that. So we keep trying to do a little better each year and to do good things for our community.
If somebody had a question about our sustainability program or about the Go Green Award, who do they contact?
They can reach out to me, Nell Boyle, and that's nell.boyle@roanokeva.gov.
Okay. Well, thank you for sharing it. It's very exciting to be recognized.
Thank you.
and appreciate you coming today.
Thank you so much.
Okay. We'll be right back. Mm-hmm.
Are you a part of the leaf solution or the leaf pollution? When you rake or blow leaves into the street, drainage ditch, or curb and gutter system, you're clogging the drainage structures, which causes an increase of street flooding. Try mulch mowing instead. A standard rotary or mulch mower will chop the leaves directly back into the turf. Composting your leaves is a great way to add nutrients to your gardens and flower beds. Or check with your locality about bag leaf pickup. Remember, only rain down the storm drain.
Welcome back. My guest is Sheila Umberger, and Sheila is the director of Roanoke Public Libraries. Sheila, we would like for you to tell us about some of the holiday programs that are coming to the library in December. Talk about that a little.
We have a lot planned. Of course, Santa will be visiting all the branches. Sometimes in connection, every single branch will have a cafe event, including mm-hmm. the Law Library, which will have a luncheon during December.
Uh-huh.
And Santa will be at some of those, but that's a good opportunity for parents to get their photo taken with Santa and visit. We also have live music at all those events.
Okay.
As far as other programs, we have the Nutcracker, scenes from the Nutcracker from Southwest Virginia Ballet.
Oh, cool.
Roanoke Children's Theater is going to be doing songs from Annie, which is one of their productions, so mm-hmm. that'll be at the library. We also have a couple of programs that are tied to a grant that we just received from the Virginia Commission of the Humanities.
Uh-huh.
And it's a racial healing grant, but
okay.
One is a Tell Your Story poetry
mm-hmm.
Thing for families, and another is, one of my favorite is a Google expedition tour of holiday sites around the world. So we did one for Harry Potter
uh-huh.
of castles.
Yeah.
So I can show you this. So you download onto your phone an app, and then we give you these readers
yeah.
to look at, and you put the phone in this device,
mm-hmm.
and then our program person will guide you in the tour. So it's really pretty cool.
That
it's like you're actually there.
Yeah.
All of our programs are family
okay.
oriented. We also have a series at every single branch of either food classes. So we have a fruitcake class.
Mm-hmm.
We have a series of teas, about teas,
mm-hmm.
as well as crafts that you can do for children maybe to make a gift for their parents
That's
or something
nice.
Like that.
Yeah.
So we try to make all of our programs family oriented.
Mm-hmm.
As we usually do that, but in the holidays we particularly work on that particular
right.
aspect.
So all of the programs are with no cost?
No cost to the programs,
uh-huh.
but thanks to both the funding we have through the City of Roanoke, but also the Roanoke Public Library Foundation,
mm-hmm.
which have been sponsoring our program since 1952. They've been in existence, so they're a nonprofit,
uh-huh.
But their whole goal is to support unique programs in the system, and so they're a big help to us in our work.
And do people have to go online and register, or do they just show up?
Just show up.
Okay.
Yeah, we don't like to do that because, you know, you want to be spontaneous and be able to come to programs
yeah.
and come to your library.
What do you think is the benefit of creating sort of this holiday special atmosphere at the libraries?
Well, I mean, again, one of the benefits of all the libraries is that we're in the neighborhoods of
that's
Roanoke,
true.
And that's actually the strength and the beauty of Roanoke is
mm-hmm.
our neighborhood. So, you know, it's your neighborhood branch, and you can just walk to it or drive to it. And
yeah.
so we just want to create that place where you can take your family and have a good time and explore different new things.
And draw them to the library to see what other things you all have to
that's
offer,
right.
correct?
That's right.
Anything you want to preview for us coming up in 2019? Any special programs? Or?
Well, we're working on programs. We'll likely do another winter reading program, which is more, it's a little bit more family, that's also family oriented, where you read to your children
right.
during the winter. But also we're working on a series of film series with the city schools and with the Grandin Theater
mm-hmm.
for Black History Month.
Okay.
And we also, in this grant that we received, the two-year grant, we'll have a series of children's authors coming in for a lot of different programs over the next 2 years. So we're very excited about that as well, because they're all Virginia authors.
If somebody had a question or wanted more information, what's the best way to get it?
The best way is to go to our social media, either our Facebook or the city's website. Mm-hmm. And we have all of our programs that you can sort by location and by type.
Okay. Well, thank you. It sounds great. I hope everybody makes it over to their local neighborhood library for the holiday season.
Oh, we're definitely ready.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Three facts about lead poisoning. Just a few particles of dust from lead-based paint are enough to poison a child. Lead from deteriorating paint can be found in the soil around the home and in older playgrounds. Since children often put their hands or toys in their mouths, washing their hands helps protect them from lead poisoning. Lead poisoning affects over 1 million children today. Find out when your home, school, and daycare center was built. If it was before 1978, it probably contains lead-based paint. Contact LeadSafe Roanoke at 853-5682 for more information.
Did you know that it takes 12 to 20 years for a cigarette butt to decompose? Cigarette butts thrown on the ground or out the window are litter, and most wash into our waterways, polluting streams, and harming stream life. Cigarette butts can also be a fire hazard. Extinguish cigarette butts in ash cans and ash trays. Litter is preventable, so remember, no ifs, ands, or buts. Don't litter.
Welcome back. My guest is Susan Jennings. Susan is Arts and Culture Coordinator for the city. Hey, Susan, we have a new program that's coming along, Find the Art.
Right.
What's the goal of that program?
Right. The goal of the program is, I don't think a lot of people realize that we have over 150 pieces in our public art collection now. So we want to get the word out about that and have people go hunt for the art.
So how does it work? Talk about that.
You can go on our Facebook or our Instagram, and you will see a little snippet of a piece of art. It won't show you the whole piece.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to figure out either the artist's name, the location, or the title.
Okay.
And send that in, and then you're eligible to win some great prizes.
Well, that sounds wonderful. What's the Arts Commission's role in these types of contests?
The Arts Commission's part of our role is to promote the arts, not just the public art program, but the idea that the city of Roanoke is a vibrant arts and cultural scene. So this really helps get the word out about that.
And do you have sponsors for the different?
We do. We have 16.
Whoa.
So that's a few too many to mention right here, but the co-op, for instance, has given us a $25 gift certificate. We have several restaurants that have given gift certificates. Relentless Fitness Studio, Magnolia Fine Art and Gifts, so a broad range.
Okay.
And we'll be giving two away each month, one through Facebook and one through Instagram.
And anybody can enter?
Anybody can enter, except for an Arts Commission member.
So this is all about bringing awareness of our public art program.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. And getting people to go out and actually visit the pieces. But I will give a little hint.
Okay.
All of our public art is online at artinroanoke.org. So if you're truly stumped and you don't know where it is, you can go there and get a little hint.
Okay. And are there other programs coming up? Anything else you want to mention
there
for
is.
Us?
There is. The other one I would like to mention is we have just put out a call for our fifth Rider on the Bus. This is a program that we do as part of Ride Solutions Art on the Bus program.
Mm-hmm.
And we partner with them and with Valley Metro. And we choose a person, a rider, to ride on the bus for a couple of months. And then they produce, it's been chat books in the past, but they produce something of their writings and their experiences when they're going out into different neighborhoods.
Yeah.
So this is a way to take the art out into the neighborhoods as well. So that application was just posted and the deadline is December 17th.
Okay, that sounds great.
Yeah.
So
the writers who have done it have really enjoyed it. And we've had everything from poets to essayists to journalists. So any type of writing.
Okay, and all of this information is on the website?
It's on our website, and the easiest way to get there is artinroanoke.org. And people can also contact me, which is susan.jennings@roanokeva.gov.
Well, we wish everybody success in Find the Art.
Thanks.
Hope a lot of people win and become familiar with our art.
I hope so, too. Yeah. That's our goal.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Okay. We'll be right back.
Hey, Melissa.
Hi.
I like your outfit.
Thank you.
No, I'm just kidding. You look ridiculous.
Keeping Roanoke streets clean and attractive takes a lot of work. The city welcomes your help. Community organizations, businesses, and individuals can volunteer through the Adopt a Street program to adopt a specific street in the city. Participants agree to clean up their location 4 times a year for 2 years. To find out more, contact the City of Roanoke's Transportation Division at 853-5837 or the Municipal Volunteer Coordinator at 853-1801 or send an email to mvp@roanokeva.gov.
Welcome back. My guest is Mayor Sherman Lee. And Mayor, we want to talk about something that happened recently, your business summit, the Mayor's Business Summit. Tell us when and where that happened.
Well, it happened on October 23rd at the CoLab over in Grandin Village. And we were excited about it.
Who benefited from this event?
Well, those business owners or those who want to become a business owner, those that currently have a small business now, and those who just want to find out about the resources, what's available, how can I do it, who can I contact to get in business, and if I have some problems, can I consult someone? So that's the vast majority of the participants in terms of coming to our summit, and we think we had a good crowd there.
Were there sponsors for this event?
Yeah, there were sponsors. Freedom First Credit Union, the City of Roanoke Economic Development, and the Roanoke Small Business Development Center. And they've been sponsors for years, and we're very pleased and proud of the work that they do.
Who were some of the speakers, just so people will know?
Well, we had a group of speakers, and they primarily were business, people who are in business or just started their business. We had Baraka Kasanga, a CEO of Valencia, a business language interpreter, who really started his business there at the CoLab, and he's been very successful. And we were also pleased to have two people who really worked themselves up from the streets. I mean, they really got involved in it. And that's Kat Pascal and Jimmy Delgado, who own a business called Spotless America, and it's a commercial cleaning business. And I was very moved by their story of how they got started. And it's so important for those in attendance to see that, to hear that, to understand the things that you go through in developing a business, that, but they've proven to be very successful. They even have a business from the farm to the table hamburger place over in Vinton.
Wow.
And I'm going to try to get over there as soon as I can. But they've been going and really making an effort to make themselves successful, and they've done a good job.
Give us an idea of the kinds of things that people learn at the business summit.
Well, they learn how to start a business if they want to. They learn that what it takes, how to become involved, and I'm appreciative of the speakers that are there, because they share with them that if you're thinking about a business, these are some of the first things you need to do, to make sure your finances are straight, to make sure you can see yourself a year or so down the road, and then just some practical things, the do's and the don'ts. You know, things like if you got to get a loan to get started, that's not a good sign for your business. And so we wanted to make sure we bring those small business people who are there to share that. And so I think it's a good exchange. We have people to come in. We had our treasurer to come to talk about taxes. That's so important. So we have an array of people to come in to give them as much information as they need, and they seem to be receptive.
It really equips them to start that business, right?
It really does.
Why do you think it's important to have events like the Mayor's Business Summit?
Well, being the mayor, I recognize that small businesses are the lifeblood of our city. We need that, and we want them to be successful. So, you know, there are a lot of big people that start businesses, but they haven't thought through what it takes. This is an opportunity for any citizen, there are no charges. They can come over, be a part of this, and understand how you really get involved and make themselves available to just understand what it takes. And so that's what I feel as mayor. I want all of our entrepreneurs to feel like they can go out and be successful. And we want to help them be successful, because if they're successful, our city is successful, and that means I'm able to cut a ribbon. And when I cut a ribbon, that means it's a great day in Roanoke.
You think we'll have some more in the future?
I look forward to it. I think we want to continue to need that. And if the reception is anywhere as it's been in the past, we want to. I get calls from a number of citizens saying, hey, how do I do this? How can I do this, especially in the mayor's office? So I said, well, look, let's bring everybody together and have a summit. So right now, I'm hoping that at some point in early or late spring, we'll have another summit.
If someone watching wants to know more about the things that you're teaching at these business summits, how do they get information about that?
Well, they can go to the city's website. They can also go to our Department of Economic Development.
Okay.
They have a biz news and, and just send, and that's something that'll buy them of what's going on. And just contact my office. We'll tell them to do, tell them what to do and, and how to get started. But the information is out there, and we have a great website that can tell you all of those things. So there are ways to find out, and we hope that people will take advantage of it.
Right. Well, it's a wonderful event, a great thing to do for the community, and thank you for doing that.
Thank you for having
me. Okay, we'll be right back.
It is important for both restaurants and homeowners to help keep our waterways clean and safe. Never pour cooking oil or grease into sinks, parking lots, or streets. The oil and grease can enter our waterways through storm drains. Always try to recycle the oil and grease or put it into the trash. If you have a spill, clean it up by using a drying agent like cat litter. Never hose down spills. Keep dumpster and trash can lids closed. Restaurants should clean floor mats and garbage cans in a mop sink. It's easy to keep our waterways clean by doing the right thing.
There's a myth out there that somebody who's using drugs is engaged in a selfish habit, that they're not hurting anybody. And I can say that's not true at all. Every drug user has somebody that they've hurt, that they've not been there for because they're under the influence, or they're using their time and money to obtain drugs. I see a lot of people in the probation office who steal from family members, steal from friends and businesses. So I can truly say that, a drug addiction and drug habit hurts everybody.
We hope you've enjoyed this month's show. Now let's take a look at what's happening this month inside Roanoke.
On November 18th, Roanoke Symphony Orchestra presents Beethoven and Shostakovich at the Jefferson Center. November 22nd, Drumstick Dash Family 5K Walk and Run in downtown Roanoke. November 22nd through January 1st, Fashions for Evergreens at the Hotel Roanoke. On November 23rd, Fantasyland at the History Museum of Western Virginia. On November 27th, Roanoke Symphony and Chorus present Hallelujah, Handel's Messiah at the Jefferson Center. On December 1st, the 2018 Jingle Bell Run at the Patrick Henry Hotel. December 1st through the 2nd, Candy Cane Express at the Virginia Museum of Transportation. On December 7th, City of Roanoke Christmas Tree Lighting and Dickens of a Christmas in downtown Roanoke. On December 8th, Breakfast with Santa at the Hotel Roanoke and Conference Center. And also on December 8th, the Southwest Virginia Ballet presents The Nutcracker at the Berglund Center.